I chose Wicks for...
Kelvin Darnell Martin was born on July 24th, 1964 in the South Bronx, New York City. His childhood nickname was Lil Shab, and Jay resulted in a shootout between Martin's group and the Hollis Crew, a stick-up gang from Jay's neighborhood. Martin's association with rappers wasn't always criminal or even hostile. Eric Berry of Eric B. and Rakim was a friend of Martin. The two developed a friendship in 1986 and became so close that Martin became a member of the Paid in Full Posse. Martin was featured in a photo with other members of the Paid in Full Posse, alongside the rap duo and other rappers and criminals on the back of Eric B. and Rakim's debut album, Paid in Full. Its title song ironically recounts the lifestyle embraced by Martin that Rakim avoided by pursuing a hip-hop career. Martin's main robbery targets were alleged drug dealers in their stash houses. His skill set expanded to include kidnapping and extortion as well. Martin would offer protection against robberies, violence, vandalism, and other forms of assault to local foreigners and drug dealers. Those who turned down this agreement would find themselves victim of assaults, which were perpetrated by Martin himself. Martin's robbery and extortion proceeds afforded him a place of distinction as the owner of a custom gold-colored Volkswagen Jetta. Martin's penchant for carrying out his assaults without attempting to conceal his identity gained him several enemies. In addition to being stabbed numerous times, it's estimated that Martin was shot at least 24 times in 9 separate incidents. Despite having never been indicted for murder, he is also believed to have at least 30 bodies. Because people were trying to kill him, Martin decided to enlist into the army. Eventually, he was given an honorable discharge and sent back from Georgia to New York.
What a crew.
I got it.
I'm stronger than that.
You know, if you punch somebody in the mouth, they like, yo, I'm up. Like, if you, right now, if you punch me in my mouth, I'm up. I'm up. I'm going to tell you right now, I'm all the way. Let me tell you, I'm all the way up. And guess what's going to happen? Once you punch me in my mouth, I'm going to get my man, Terrence, K.O. Lewis, I'm going to get him to punch me in my mouth. Because then I want to get double the money, but I'm going to say you did all of it.
No, because it ain't going to matter. And I'm going to take the same kind of money that you would get and give it to the homie. And go shoot the gap. Double time, man. Because they finally get a chance to run. Then it starts feeling fun. All of a sudden, everybody don't remember nothing. Nah, that lawsuit, no, I won't do that.
Oh, but wait, but wait.
I'm with that. It shot me, then shot at the ambulance.
Yeah, but wait.
This ain't right. They go, nah.
Okay, so the case is...
Hey, look, let me ask you a question. How much you think it'll cost to kill somebody?
Nowadays, couple stacks.
About 5,000.
Yeah, couple stacks.
But why would it cost so much to go through the court proceeds? Don't make sense, right? Yeah, even this up. Get him and the girl. I don't like the girlfriend.
Oh. I need to go out of it, man. I need to go out of it.
Oh, man, go on. We're going to double that because the legal fees will be about $40,000, $50,000 anyway, right? I'm going to give you 40, man. This is a discount. It's a $10,000 discount in this one, man. Kill both of them dead. Well, I'm at the price of life. Well, I grew up at the price of life is cheap. So if you got the money, if you got the bag, it's going to happen. When you drop it, it's a go. So tell me who this is you think I won't drop the bag? That's what you think?
Nah, look, hey.
You got to be kidding me. Like, that's the easiest thing in the world.
I'm just asking.
When that shit come out, they gonna say, yo, this thing.
I love y'all.
It's just you and me. You know what I be, yo.
That's it.
That's what I'm talking about, boy. Nothing's all. Let y'all niggas know that I love y'all. I fuck with y'all and I appreciate y'all. You know what I'm saying? I wouldn't be nothing without y'all.
When that shit come out. Say, yo, this thing
crazy,
man.
Shorty go jogging every morning, and she make me breakfast almost every morning, and she take a nigga pic before she leave the door. I be waking up with pics before a nigga on it, and
And every weekend, my shorty coming over. Shorty can fend the out, but she like flashing over. She ain't driving no Camry, she pulling in a Rover. With her hair so curly, I like she said, but you know about love. I tell you everything, I got what you need. Walk up in the store and get what you want. What you please, we about to get it on. Take off them drums, it's just you and me. You know what I be on, I'm about to go wrong, baby. Cause I like what I see. Look, baby, I see I ain't gon' front. You got my heart beating so fast, words I can't pronounce. And I be getting the chills every time I feel your touch. I be looking at the top, and girl, it's only us. All I need is a choice. And girl, I told you once, don't make me tell you twice. I know you see this print through my page that I know you like. And your ass be looking so fat when it be in a place. And I'm going straight to the top, so you ain't afraid of heights. You always keep me right, for a fact, you never left. Through all the trials and tribulations, always had my best. So here's 5,500, go and get your rest. Still rubbing on your butt, still kissing on your neck. Hate that about it. Niggas know I had to swing, I had to make a play. I had to apply the pressure, cause you my hidden treasure. I think I'm falling in love. She said, what you know about love? I tell you everything. I got what you need. Woke up in the store and get what you want. Get it. You get what you please. We bout to get it on. Take off them drugs. It's just you and me. You know what I need, yo.
Seven 37 a.m. in the morning. March 31st. Food, yogurt, 2 milks, and about 4 waters. Dogs barking, officers are coming, stepping through my door. Took 1,200 milligrams, got abandoned, can't find the Flexerol.
Para continuar.
Yes, sir.
It's all Shawnee Benny. What's going on, bro?
Para volver a escuchar su mensaje,
you call us?
Para continuar grabando, oprima dos. Para borrar.
How you doing, officer?
What's going on? You call us?
Can I speak to you with the other officer, sir?
You're gonna speak to both of us, but you speak to him.
Para cancelar este mensaje, apriete la estrella.
Do you mind changing places, please?
We're not going to do that.
Okay.
Para volver a escuchar su
mensaje, oprima 1. I'm not a criminal.
Para borrar y volver a grabar su mensaje, oprima 3.
You got internet?
Para opciones de entrega, oprima
4. I forget your name, officer.
Nissan.
Para cancelar este mensaje, apriete la estrella. Para
I'm conflicted, Nisi.
Oprima el signo de número o cuelgue.
You've been one of the few officers from the 5th, aside from Ryder, to see me in the chair. The difference is that you put me in the chair with Poser, and you helped me get to court. Meason, if you think that this has anything to do with that woman outside, the primary reason, Anna Benny, I'm sorry, sir, but I don't talk to you.
Why is that?
Um, If you'd like me to explain it to you, I will do so at a different time. You had a different partner, and sick of something, sycamore or something with a sick.
Okay.
Cicatello was here with you, and I was here in my house alone. Please, some officer needs him. Would you please mind taking that?
What is it?
It is a apparently a suspicious. It's a suspicious occurrence report. Please look at it. That way I don't have to talk so much. You won't have to be here talking to me for forever.
So why'd you call us today, Dayron?
You called me Forey.
Forey, why are we here? What's the issue today? Because I understand you called 7 times last night. To the night officers, you spoke with officers... Azara and
No. You were here four times, and I guess I called 7 times. What is that piece of paper that you still have that I need desperately? What does that indicate to you?
Missing the check.
Does it say that anyone took it from me? Does it talk about fraud? Because the very second I said fraud to a 911 operator, that young woman was like, I'm sending someone to your house now.
Mm-hmm.
You're still wiping the cold out your eyes?
What's up?
You're still wiping the cold out your eyes?
Yeah, man, I just got on.
I know. It's tough, right? Maybe we're just having a tough day, Anna Benny. That day with Cicatella.
Well, here's the thing. When I remember when we were here and we were trying to speak with you and you were knocking bottles and food over your table. That's why. You were making it difficult for us to understand what was going on.
You weren't here before. It's just that you arrived. When you arrived, Donna Benny, Cicatella had already been here.
Mm-hmm.
And I wound up calling Azara. Yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
It's because he wouldn't give me his first name. We're on a first name basis, right?
We're not supposed to give our first name.
You and I are beyond the first name basis, just like Grogan.
You
saw me sitting in the chair.
Was good. You had your fucking gear on, shoes.
Was there a difference?
Hell yeah.
What was the difference? That I don't look like a retarded, crazy durr, right? In the chair, it looks a little bit different, nice, right? So, yeah. I got my Puma clothes.
Yeah, you had a sponsorship deal, man, or something.
And also, I amended things with Poulter, because you know what a poser is, right? Like, slang. Yeah, but his name is Poulter. Yeah, with a Z, I found out. He was talking to me like a regular person, then she almost dropped me on the street. I was like, this guy, I made it to court, and it was great.
Yeah, that was a good day.
Yeah, I like Ice Cube or whatever. There is a court order here somewhere for Anna Benny that was on the table before. Because the reason that I'm calling you and you're here, okay, is primarily for this thing, the piece of paper that you saw. I have been in constant communication with what I'm going to say. I called him an acquaintance, but just so you and Nisi get an understanding, he is a connect. Are we all in that awesome?
Oh, yeah.
That woman outside.
Went to college.
He's like, I went to college. That's funny. So aside the one piece of paper that is here.
Mm-hmm.
Sapienza, because the minute I said fraud, he's like, who took your check, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's like, tell me the name. Because I like to handle street shit. I'm like this, right? But I can't always go to a courthouse to deal with shit. like this stuff with my family, family squabbles, the domestics. That's a family court issue. She put a order of protection, and also someone Klepsis. He helped me out because I'm like, yeah, I already know. No, this is a refrain from order. And then I read it at the very bottom. The only reason that I kind of lapsed on it, I was like, remember all this shit that I explained? It's at the bottom. Is that you got to pay to specific behavior. Mm-hmm. Before you guys showed up here, right? It's not like I just don't connect everything together. I was half-ass awake, half-ass asleep. And when I had the argument with Bonilla and Azaro yesterday, I'm like, I don't have water. It's like, we're not here to get you water. I don't have food. I don't got shit. And she was right outside. So she knows what she's doing wrong. I woke up and I'm like, okay, what's she doing in my room? I see Azara outside and she tries to talk to me, right? And Azara told my mother, Azara said to her, and you know, you dismissed my mother. And this is in a movie in Dune that just came out, you know, like little kid to Charlemagne, you dismissed my mother in her own home. Like that's exactly, yeah. That's what Azara did, but he's not like one of these witches. He said, don't talk to him. Just put the food down. Like she was, like I woke up because I'm guessing she said something to me. Mm-hmm. How much time have you been in here?
So what I'm trying to ask, right, I'm listening and I'm trying my best to understand. From what you just told, what were you trying to accomplish today that my partner and I are here?
What I'm trying to accomplish today is I'm trying, and if Nisi, between the both of you, if you can agree, is what I have here considered a suspicious occurrence report for the January check that I lost?
Well, I can't say that off the top of my head because I'm not familiar with that case report. I know my partner just saw it, so I don't know the details of the whole situation.
Understood. Would you allow me the same amount of time that Sapienza allowed me? Which I said, sir, give me 4 minutes, right, with uninterrupted. And then he's like, all right, you got 4 minutes. Because he kept interrupting me. Like, obviously, you gentlemen are listening to me. Mm-hmm. And I've expended my 4 minutes. But I had the email ready, like I sent to a pension planner, and I was trying to tell the 911 operator, don't send police officers over here, because all I want to do is read what I'm going to send to this man to make sure that I don't fuck up a form. Excuse me. I apologize, Nisim and Anibeni, okay? I don't like using profanity at any time, because that just leads to, like, arguments. No, just, it's not even letting it out. Sometimes between men, it condenses the issue. I'm talking about the fucking pension planner. That's why I know, because I'm kind of like diminishing his status right there, what he does. But I'm also trying to, like, expedite the process here. Because, as you know, you don't have to deal with her. You don't have to go ask her anything. She's got nothing to do with this. I only mention this because certain things will prompt you to move a little bit faster on things that you need to take care of. Mm-hmm. So because I did send the email before Balcunes, because he was the person that made this particular report.
Okay.
Yesterday morning, yes, sir. Because I did send that as Balcunes. I couldn't believe this, and I understood it. Balcunes was here, Sapienza was out there. But the last thing Balcunes said to me, I have to leave. Like somehow I had anything to do with it. Anyway, he said, I have no choice. Like, I have to leave. I don't have a choice. I was like, you don't have a choice. I'll do the face. I'll do the reaction. Could you time me, please, Miss Officer Anabeni? You are a police officer. No matter how I feel about, you know, interaction, is it fine if you look at your watch and say, all right, you got 4 minutes?
Well, I can't speak for him, but...
Neeson, is it okay if you look at your watch and tell me exactly what time it is? Okay,
you want us to do that right now? Or you?
It's 7:51. Oh. I want 4 minutes to be able to read this.
Mm-hmm.
So you want us to tell if it's all right or not?
No, this is different because
let me interrupt you. All right, what are you trying to get done right now?
Let me read this.
It was about the suspicious occurrence.
Let me read this thing.
Go ahead, read it.
Okay. Are you ready? Sorry. He said the form was fine. I just need to change something.
Who said
my
that?
Pension planner.
Who said that?
My pension planner.
Okay.
Are you understanding this?
All right, yeah, but about what, though?
Submitting a form of fraud to the bank that company deals with if anything is ever lost. Basically, that man is making me do his job, because I'm guessing it's a part of procedural things that are now in place at that place.
Is it a bank?
Yes.
All right, so they do their own private investigation.
I understand that within the form it says if you have a police report, I also have to put down the name of the person that I think took the check.
Okay.
Or committed the fraud.
All right.
I don't want to be implicated in it. Let me read this. You ready?
Yes.
All right. This is where you're gonna, I think, Neeson, I wish I was sitting down, you're gonna understand, Anabeni, that I'm a 43-year-old, like, adult child, as this girl said it, but you're gonna have some respect for me, and I'm closing my eyes. I don't like boosting myself up. I wrote to him, is the form okay? He said, yeah, it looks okay, just change this. Do I need to write the one name of the individual that spearheaded duck in capital, fraudulent singular activity, and or no additionally, in support of the form submission, provide and two official suspicious occurrence in quotations. That man does not know what the fuck that is. I've never received one. I learned that at Winthrop Hospital. I'm guessing it's written in pink, right? Mm-hmm. Just like everything else. Suspicious occurrence report, signed document from the authorities. Mm-hmm. To assist in the speedy determination. I didn't say investigation because I want an ultimate determination as to whether I'm going to get my money. No, the reference support authentic report for the loss of the January 24th, 2024 LTDB, long-term disability, that's what it is, an acronym, is being prepared for signature and verification of this matter. I added that in as Sapienza and Bakunas were outside. Very quickly. Like, I write this shit in under 20 minutes. Yet I only need such for jurisdictional reference. However, if nothing further is either going to be helpful or necessary, as questioned above, aside from the change of D4E, mm-hmm. right? Because I put D4E, you know, like how you called me Dayron and then 4E.
Yeah, you like D4E.
Yeah, and then when I first heard that shit, excuse my language, Anubani. Anibeni, when I heard that shit from my Puerto Rican, beautiful, I mean, Puerto Rican, hot ass legal system, but she had her face was all like kind of messed up. Her judge was a traffic cop.
Mm-hmm.
She said, "Fori, get me the I'm like, who the fuck are you talking to? It's Mr. Right in the world. This is when I was like in my 20s. I said, I looked at her and I'm like, you know, when I own my law firm, I don't want people kissing my ass and calling him Mr. Ford. That just sounds weird. I'm like, you know what? And people, they always butcher my name. They're like, hey, Day-Day, D, Devontae Swing, Dayron. Anyway, I'm not done. Please know that I do not want to be implicated with the connection of an instance of the fraud that took place as the 01/2024 LTDB check was never signed or endorsed, given the authority and eligibility I have to receive said funds. I await your reply. The reason you're here, and if great. What?
Sounds really good.
I was a paralegal, and that took a lot of technical work and a legal assistant. I am effectively like a lawyer without like a JD. I can go take the bar, like, can catch me if you can. But people don't know this. After I do that, I'm going to have to go before, like, a panel of, like, judges for New York State. They have to check my credentials and what I've done. They're going to look up my arrest background or if I've done anything wrong, right? And then someone will make a decision as to whether or not I have enough clout in the community to put a JD behind my name. Because mm-hmm. after that, you're going to have to call me counselor. Mm-hmm. And I don't want that shit. I do not want that shit. So do I seem educated enough to deal with this on my own, Anna Benny?
Yes, but my question to you...
go ahead.
You've been rambling off, a little off tangent. I understand what you're saying. You just said before what you want for us to do, and then you just went off on the tangent. So I'm trying to ask you again. What do you need our assistance for in regards to what you just told us?
Nathan, I answered that question.
All right, so
because Officer Anabeni is correct, and I the ChatGPT, mm-hmm. and you can tell Grogan, Nathan, like, he's got the most advanced AI. Yeah, it's not like a chatbot. No. He's paying for it, $100 a year. Mm-hmm. Because I did ramble off. You asked me that question numerous times, and I did answer it just once.
Okay.
But because you're standing up, and you're not like laying down, just like, yay, I'm laying down and eating food, you know? You're not relaxed. You're not at your most relaxed. If you were sitting down in a chair.
All right, Dayron, what do you need for us to do?
Neesum, I apologize, Officer Anabeni, I didn't mean any disrespect.
You said you wanted us to tell you if that sounded good, right? That sounded great.
No. I need a suspicious, the same suspicious occurrence report mm-hmm. for the check that you saw for January. Mm-hmm. I need one for February. Because now it's not just one. But two checks. But
it does. What evidence do you have about the other check?
Huh?
What evidence do you have about the other check?
I provided that evidence to Sapienza when he gave me this.
Did he do a report on it?
I love this guy.
Did he?
I gotta love you. Yes, he did. I handed it to Neesum.
But I thought that was the January check from was it the check from yesterday? The suspicious occurrence from yesterday?
This is the suspicious occurrence report for the January check,
okay.
Which you just asked me mm-hmm. if Sapienza did he do a report?
So Sapienza did that one.
Yes, and I don't believe that this is a suspicious occurrence report, but because I love this fucking guy so fucking much,
yeah.
I mean, I actually do love you, man, because getting me into that wheelchair. My own brothers haven't done that.
Yeah, we did a good job that day. So you want another...
I don't mean to keep harping on that day.
What was the conclusion they did with the January check? What was their conclusion?
This? There has been no conclusion because I move like a snail when it comes to this.
So why don't you figure out the January one and then something at a time.
Let me just cut you off. Remember, so I'm not saying that you're lying, right, Flory? So remember when me and Sukatella were here and he was saying you can't be falsifying things, right? I'm not saying that, but I just want to bring it to your knowledge.
Oh my God! Look, man,
Flory,
I'm in some shit right now, and Benny, let me speak.
You're not listening to me, though. All right?
I'm not. I am not because
okay.
What do you want us to do? Please, right at this moment, gentlemen, okay? Because you understand that I have numerous domestic disputes report, right?
Mm-hmm.
You just said you can't be falsifying things.
Correct.
Right? Correct. What is the definition of fraud? Officer Anibeni.
I don't know. You tell me.
I don't know either. And you actually just said. You just. If I were to tell a judge, any attorney, any fucking Elon Musk, if they ask me, listen, what is the definition of fraud? I am going to, like, no joke, in the hardest way possible. You know how you pinpoint, you ask someone a direct question or a leading question? Right? Or you cross-examine. That's my career, Anibeni.
Mm-hmm.
Please, hold this report in your hands, whether you want to read it or not.
I'm not touching it.
Why?
I'm not touching it. But please tell me what you want us to do today in regards to why you called us.
Got it. Neesam. I'm very good at getting to the point.
I keep asking you, Mr. Anibeni. You're not telling me. You're not telling me.
Mr. Anibeni.
Good.
You went off on a tangent. You didn't ramble. The day that you and Cicatella were here has nothing to do with today.
It does, though. It does, because you keep making false statements about stuff. From my understanding, they made a suspicious occurrence off a check, right? I wasn't here to investigate that. So what you can do with that, and you were telling us with the bank, forward that to the bank to where they could do their investigation and see if there has been fraudulent activity in your account. That's what you need to do.
I'm going to do that by pressing a button on that screen. I do that.
Correct.
And I ruin someone's life. He goes to jail and I lose my connect on the street.
Right.
You gotta be careful with what you say.
Why is that?
Because you're basically calling me a liar.
I'm not calling you a liar. I'm trying to tell you that be wary of what you want us to do, because if you're falsifying stuff, that could lead to problems. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, he's looking out for you.
All right, so what would you like us to do?
I'll tell you.
That sounds great. I would send that.
I will tell you, but
well,
I'd like you to do.
I've been asking you.
You get disrespected very easily. Who's going to make the report? Will it be Officer Neesam or will it be you?
Well, first of all, you have to tell us what you want.
Give me either this pink sheet, and I'm giving you an option, or this, for the February check that was lost. So I can write to this pension planner and tell him, listen, you're going to have to invalidate the check that you mailed to my home.
Done. All right. Nice.
Are you going to do it in the pink?
It was February 25th.
Are you going to do it in the pink?
It's going to be done how we're going to do it, all right? But I'm just saying. Just be
warned. Do you know the amount?
What it's going to be?
Do you know the amount?
What it's going to be is going to be a lost check.
Do you know the amount?
What's the amount?
$732.50. Here, you should probably take this.
I don't need that.
And
because this is a new event that you're telling me of a lost check.
I know, but it's the same. It's the exact same thing, and it'll probably help you.
Give us 5 minutes. You want the door closed?
Open, please.
All right.
I have my mother come in here. Ellos todavía no se han ido. ¿En dónde están las gafas que estaban en el piso que Cristian?
Yo no quiero argumento. Yo me voy ahorita. Me voy a ir ahorita. Quiero que lo sepa. ¿Ok?
¿En dónde están las gafas que estaban en el piso? Usted entró a este cuarto y la policía estaba afuera y le dijo que no me hablara. ¿Cierto?
Por favor. Yo me voy ahorita, regreso hasta el miércoles.
La policía le dijo a usted que no me hablara.
Pero estoy hablando para que no sepa. No me hable.
Got it. Para que yo lo sepa, está bien. Le va a hablar, son los policías.
Y en 2 semanas no voy a estar aquí.
Usted ya ha dicho muchas que usted dice las cosas y no las hace. Bueno, yo soy muy diferente. No, no me va a dar cuenta de ni mierda. Yo apenas quiero que coja sus cosas, coja toda su mierda del cuarto de atrás y de la sala y que se vaya de aquí. Vamos a ver, porque ahorita los policías van a tener que resolver esto. La jueza le dijo, váyase de esa casa. No es porque es que yo me desperté y había esos policías aquí. Y usted se cree que está, usted marcó a la policía, me dijeron. Porque ella llamó primero, en ese instante. Y ya, eso está ahí, ellos dije. Cuando entren, usted busque su reporte, hágalo ya. Busque su reporte y hágalo ya. No, sí, no, usted no es cristiano. Ok. ¿Usted cree que me va a ganar a mí? Sáquese puta perra ese y fue puta cuarto. Y déjeme con mi perro aquí. Masito. A esa estúpida le compró carne. Mire. Miro. No. No. Eso es para Masito. Masito.